Hello everyone, this is Yang Zuji. I'm a senior product manager at Amazon Redshift. In next 15 minutes, I will show you how you can easily build access control and governance with the native solution in Amazon Redshift. I will start with use case analysis, then introduce three significant existing features, followed with another three most recently released features. All these features in today's session focus on authentication and authorize your user to access Redshift data. Suppose you work in a financial service firm and you are using Redshift to store and perform analysis on a wide range of data sets, such as trading details, pricing, and equity information. You share this data with your traders, clients, and risk managers, also consumed by various users across your firm. But not every user is entitled to see all the data. To track this data and access requests without the support from Redshift, you need to spend a great deal of resources to build a complex tool and define which user is entitled to what data. Let's start with role-based access control, aka RBAC. RBAC is a very powerful feature. It allows you to systematize your management of user permission and access. For example, suppose we have a role called role one, which has been granted as a system privilege A and object privilege B. Now you can just grant this role one to one or more users. All these users can perform the tasks which are specified by privilege A and B. And all the actions of this user are now monitored by roles. This user can only perform actions specified by the two privileges and they cannot do anything else. If you look at on the screen, there are some other properties provided by Redshift. We allow you to assign multiple roles to the same user, and one user can inherit a nested roles. Also, multiple privileges can assign to the same role. So we give you flexibility to do the management and simplify the process how to do it. So let me ask, have you ever tried to figure out the complicated user access to roles by creating different kinds of views or integrating with other tools to help it out? To be honest, with time going, you will find it's getting complicated to manage increasing number of views and the scalability is kind of bad. So to solve this need, last year, we released the support of role-level security. And how it works is we use an out-of-box role called SecAdmin, who can create RS policy, manage RS policy, and attach the policy to different kind of roles and grant the role to the end user. Now, the different user associated with different RS policy, when they access the table, they will see the different record within the table. We allow you to attach multiple RS policies to the same table, and we support the AND syntax between these policies. And for your security, whenever the RS is enabled on your table, for all the user who doesn't have RS policy associated with, they will lose their access to this table unless you assign a policy to them. If you are using a third-party identity provider such as Microsoft Azure AD, you will be benefited in this feature. It's called Native Identity Provider Federation because it simplifies administration by sharing identity and group membership. from your external IDP provider to Redshift and enable Redshift to natively process your third-party tokens, identities, and group permissions. How it works is, assume you are using Azure AD. With this enhancement, you can register your Azure AD as an identity provider with Redshift. Then database role will be created with the same name as your group in Azure AD. And when you log into Redshift, the user's group membership will be retrieved from Azure AD and mapped to the right database role. You can perform all the privilege given by the Azure AD. That sounds cool, right? But we have more for this year. We launched many security features in this year, and I will pick three features to share with you. The first one is dynamic masking. It's also built on top of the RBAC. It allows you to protect your PII, PCI sensitive data by writing a familiar SQL syntax. So you can see this is very similar workflow as RS. We also have a SecAdmin in the center who can create data masking policy and also manage these masking policies with the roles. For user one and user two here who has different data masking policy, when they access the same table, they will see the different results. User A see the partial masked column and user two see the fully masked column. We give you flexibility to do any format you want, like partial masking, fully masking, obfuscated masking, or using your own user-defined function to do the data masking. We also allow you to have different masking conditions. You can use the column in the same table as the condition column, or you can use another table as the lookup table to define the masking policy. As I mentioned before, if you are looking for the architecture across AWS services and you want to unify the service to govern your data, then you can use AWS Link Formation. And you can define the database table, column, and row level access permission of your Redshift data shares inside of Link Formation. So when you do the data sharing, instead of sharing the data with another Redshift cluster, you can share with Link Formation first. And the administrator in Link Formation can apply all these permission policies to data sharing and then I'll share to the data consumer. The last but not least, we have the single sign-on support with identity provider in serverless. So now you can pass a list of database roles granted to a user based on his identity provider group membership. And as an administrator, you can configure your identity provider to pass this role by adding the principal tag as SAML attributes. And you can use single sign-on support with Redshift Query Editor V2, JDBC, ODBC clients, and Data API. All right, after getting some insight of all this feature, I will give you a demo and combine the features of RBAC, RS, and DDM. So in this demo, I prepared a table called credit cards. And in this table, it has information, customer ID, ACE fraud, and credit card number information. I will use this table to show you how to apply the RS and DDM policy on the table and give a different user different privilege to access the table. We can go ahead, create some user and roles. And these users will be the user we use to access the same table, and we suppose them to see the different result. In this demo, I will create four masking policies for the four users I created before. The first masking policy is to mask all the correct characters in the credit card number, and I replace all the character with the cross symbol. In the second masking policy, I actually use a user-defined function called redact credit card. And in this user-defined function, it only masks the middle six digits. The rest of the digits keep the same. In the masking policy, CC partial, it calls the user-defined function and make the partial mask. The third masking policy is conditional masking policy. We use if fraud column as the condition and apply the masking based on if fraud's value. The fourth masking policy, it shows the raw data. We can go ahead and attach this policy to the table and assign to the role. For the fully masked policy, I assign to the public means everyone in the public who get the same access, which is they cannot see any digits in the credit card. And for the partial mask, assign to customer service role and give it a priority 10. To be noted that the priority number here indicates what level of the masking policy is. If the higher the priority means the policy can be applied first. For the conditional data masking policy, I give it to the role fraud prevent. And for the raw data policy, I give it to the auditor role, and it has the highest priority. And to track the result, I will set the authorization session to different user and see what they can see from the table. For user Kate, who got a customer service role, she will see the middle six digits unmasked. So this is expected. And for user Kin, only when the is fraud is true. This is conditional masking. That's right. And for user Bob, who has an auditor role, I believe he can see all the digits. And for user Jin, who didn't get any advanced privilege, who can only see the fully masked credit card. All right, so this is how the data masking work. And let's go ahead to create some RS policy, see how the RS help you to filter the data record. In this RS policy, I said when the is fraud is true, the role will shows up. And I attach the policy to the role fraud print role. And the very important that for RS, there is one extra step is turn on the RS policy. Because the user Kin got the fraud prevent role, we can check what Kin can see in the table right now. Okay, the table is successfully filtered by its fraud, and only when it's true, the record showing. Yep, so that's it for the demo. Cool. I'm so happy to be here and spend last 15 minutes to talk through six features I picked for you, and you can use it to build your access control and federation with Amazon Redshift native solution. Here are some resources link. You can scan the QR code and get into the documentation and read through and try it out on your own platform. Thank you for being with me. Here is my LinkedIn link, and I'm looking forward to connecting with you and hear from you. Thanks.